your name still, call the sea to still, the rage in me to still, every wave at your name. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, your silence fear. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble. Jesus, Jesus, cause these bones to live, cause these lungs to sing once again. I will praise Jesus, Jesus. You make the darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus. Your silence fear, Jesus, Jesus. You make the darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus.
Your silence fear,
your silence fear.
Blog Talk Radio.
Now the decision has been made by God that He will bring the judgment to the earth. He will start shaking the earth like never before. And the judgment that are coming very soon now, okay, will now be held back. The Father will now hold back. The Father will bring the judgment to the earth. Okay? And the earthquake that is tied with California, okay, and how he's shown other people, it's tied with Mexico, Argentina, and many other countries around. This earthquake will practically destroy California. And the Lord has warned the people in California, his people, to get out of California. All of their world dies in California.
The odor of death is in the air, as is the stench of lies and corruption. A nation of blind and deaf, the land of the unrepentant and the home of the future captives and slaves. You will not be free because only the truth sets you free. Because you have removed me and my ways, I am against you. The once great lady, a harlot, now deplorable, murderers, reprobates, without understanding and natural affection. I have sent you my messengers and prophets, and they have preached in your city streets. They have shouted warnings from the rooftop. You have ignored them and tried to silence my words, the words I put in their mouths. A whirlwind of fire. I ask you now, do you know it's me? Yes, I am. I am a forgiving God. Have you turned from your rebellion and sins? Judgment is upon you now. Judgment is upon you now. Judgment is upon Babylon, the USA, now. Do you know it's me yet? Oh, dear. Okay, do you know it's me yet? I heard that for almost 2 weeks, here and there, all day long. I didn't get the prophecy until yesterday. Was that in there? I said this before. Something major is coming. Everybody is getting prepared for it. Make sure your house is in order, and make sure you're ready yourself and your family is. Whether they like it or not, whether they laugh at you or not, just tell them what's happening.
The word of the Lord comes to America. America, you have been weighed in the balance and you have been found wanting. I have been long suffering with you, America, and yet you throw your sins in my face and laugh at me and deny me and reject me. So have I rejected you. Your days are numbered, America, and there will be none, no, not one, that will come and help you, because I, the God of the universe, have determined that you shall receive all that you have given unto mankind. I am going to send my judgment, which has already started. I'm sending more judgment and more judgment on America. As the city of Gibeah, I shall send an ambush against your country. You will be in a war before long, and this war you will not be victorious, says the Lord. For my hand is against you, America, and you will fall into utter destruction, and the world will be shaken by what they see come upon you, because you have laughed in my face one time too many. You have made sin a joke. You have put your pollution into what I intended to be the church. The church is sleeping. The church has compromised. The church has allowed sin to rule inside its walls. That's why I, God of the universe, have closed down your buildings that you call the church. And I'm telling my remnant, come out, come out, come out of those buildings, saith the Lord of hosts. They are a stench in my nostrils. They go after their bulletins and their programs and their agendas, but not mine, saith the Lord. They won't let me have the liberty inside the buildings to do and say my will. Therefore, I am the one who brought them to close, and I will keep them closed, that my remnant may shine like never before, that the world may see the true church in my people, saith the Lord of hosts. Those of you, they'll know who you are. You've been faithful. You've been humble before me. You have bent the knee. You have bowed. You have worshipped me. You have called upon me. You have read my word. You have studied my word. You have believed my word. For in not many days hence, as I told the disciples of long ago, I will pour into you a more portion of my spirit, saith the Lord. I will fill your cups to overflowing, so that you will be able to go out into the highways and hedges of life and show people who I am. I am the great I am of Moses. I am the father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I am your father. I am your father, and I have much in store for you. Hold fast to that which is good, which is me, which is Jesus. Jesus. Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and he is soon to come and call you from this world. But until that hour, tarry, tarry, tarry and work while it is day, for soon the night cometh, and my people will work no more. They will enter into their rest, saith the Lord of hosts. They will enter into their rest that I have prepared for them. Prepare ye today. Today is the day of salvation. Reject me no more, or you will be forever, forever lost, saith the Lord.
Not as they seem. They are playing out as it seems on stage. They have crafted their plans. The enemy smiles. He knows the plans of attack. He knows the enforcement coming upon the American people. While he quivers into life, you, my children, shall fight. A war has been waged. The enemy Satan stands mightily in his plan. He is front and center stage. A war is waged. Watch to see how it is played out before this nation. Do not take the bait. You must be diligent in all you do now. No time remaining. You must make haste. Are you thinking of earthly things and about holidays, a time of rejoicing and raising your voices? Where is my praise? I raise the dead from their graves. Where will you lay when all is said and done? Finished you'll be. No more time for repentance. No time to seek me. No time left. What will you do? Seek me while I may be found. Soon there is rubble all around. Seek me while I can still be found. I will not allow the enemy to carry out his evil plan. It is a total annihilation against this nation. Weapons of mass destruction he wishes to use. Like a lit fuse, he will blow, and you won't know what time it is. You, America, are truly and foolishly deceived. Believe in your one true King. Believe with all your being. For in Christ you must be, not foolishly hanging around while everything around you comes crashing down. On your knees I should find you, humbly seeking forgiveness from the Master. Those who serve the King and Master will survive and thrive. Those who are of another will soon die. Do not die in your sin. So much sin is found. Sadly, you continue to serve and seek the Master in disguise. Be wise as a serpent and as gentle as a dove. My beloved, you are found wanting, unapproaching your King. Why is it? Because you seek a King of earth to replace me. Do you not see the only King that is and shall be is me? Your Messiah soon returns. Will I find you repentant and worthy of my holy kingdom? Or will you be foolish and continue to deny me? You will have to choose soon. It will play out as a movie, but believe me, it is now become your reality. You must choose me now and do it quickly. Time is quickly fading. Time you'll never get back. Do not seek the desires of your flesh, nor the things, material things of this earth. They are given and presented only to entice you. But in the end of all things, it's a trap. Trap, snap, release. What release? You have entered the time of the beast. Beware of his schemes and what he has up his sleeve. All will be led to slaughter. My sheep will weep. You did not keep your first love near thee. I weep for thee. My hope is solemn rest for thee. But those who continue to follow the ways of man shall weep, and no amount of relief will lighten the blow. Seek me all. Seek me this day and every day after. I see all that is being done. Behind earth's scene, scheming and conniving to get your way. When you're born of my Holy Spirit, you will not desire these earthly treasures in earthen vessels. You will be seen as diamonds in the rough. I see all things. I see a need of repentance from my children. The world will choose their own. Nevermore will they roam, for they will choose this, their home. Find no peace here, my children. The only peace you shall desire is of me, Yeshua, your loving King. Soon you will not care what you'll eat, nor where you'll sleep. Everyone saved and unsaved will be put to the test by the beast in a last attempt to see if he will keep thee or you will be set free from the enemy, for he will be released. And at that time, I receive all that belongs to me. Nevermore can he go back and forth to accuse thee, for you will dine in glory with your everlasting King.
Soonest after this earthquake comes in California, there's a soon-to-come tsunami. All right, very close after the earthquake in California happens. All right, the Lord's been speaking to me about this, mostly showing these things to me. And this earthquake, this tsunami that is coming after the earthquake in California, it's going to hit New York, it's going to hit New Jersey, Connecticut will be affected, and Boston, downtown Boston, will be affected very, very bad. okay? And I see the damage after this tsunami hit, all right? And I see Boston, most of the city.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. My end. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Praise your name, Yeshua. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Okay, sounds good. Thank you, brother. Okay, praise God. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise you, Yeshua. Yeshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Lord's hour. God bless you. God bless you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Jesus. Praise your name, Yeshua HaMashiach. Praise your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father God, I pray in Jesus' name that you will touch your people tonight. Hallelujah. Give me words, Lord. And you, Holy Spirit, you're the one who's going to minister your people tonight. I pray, Holy Spirit, that you will touch the people's heart and their mind. Minister. Minister to them. Minister to them, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Jesus, you're welcome here, Jesus and the Holy Spirit. Father God, I pray in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, that you will touch your people tonight. This is a message of a lot of things that was going on in the world right now. God's judgment is upon the world now. He's soon. He's so quickly to come. Hallelujah. Nobody knows the day and the hour, but we all are seeing what's happening around the world. Father God, I pray that you will send archangels from your holy throne around me, my family, and every listener in the Lord's hour. Cover us with your holy and mighty blood, Jesus. We repent, Jesus, from all kind of a sin that we have committed against you. Cleanse us, Lord. Cleanse us from head to toe. Cleanse us, Jesus. Hallelujah. We repent. I repent, Jesus. I repent from all type of a sins that I have committed against you. Everything that I have said, everything that I have touched, everything that I have done, forgive me, Lord, and cleanse me, wash my sins away with your holy and mighty blood. Yes, Lord. Holy Spirit, take charge of my protection. Holy Spirit, take charge of every listener protection. Hallelujah. Cover us with your holy and mighty blood, all of us, and our families, Jesus. And in the mighty name of Jesus, I bind every evil spirit from north, south, east, west, up and down. In Jesus' name, I bind them all in Jesus' name. I send them all to the pit of hell. I break the powers by the blood of Jesus, and I send them all to the pit of hell in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Clear the air, Lord. I pray, Father God, that you will clear the air and deal with them all. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray, Father God. Hallelujah. Praise your name. Praise your name, Jesus. Welcome, my brothers and sisters. God bless you. Hallelujah. 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 God is good. God is good. Welcome in the chat room. Shalom. Shalom. Consuelo Riveros. Excuse me, everyone who is in the Lord's hour, who's listening in the Lord's hour. My brothers and sisters, as we have seen judgment already. I was watching and I'm paying attention. Everything was going on. Central America got really bad hit by two huge hurricanes, Eta and Iota. These two devastated hurricanes hit Central America, Nicaragua, Honduras, Guatemala, and have left nothing but misery there, have left nothing but destruction, more poverty. And it's unbelievable to see what this hurricane left. It looks, it's apocalyptic, my brothers and sisters. You can search that up. I mean, houses are flooded. The river, many, some rivers, they came out and flooded all the area. Houses are, the water is above the houses. Thousands and thousands of people without jobs. Many people, thousands of people lost their houses. They lost it all. All. It's unbelievable. And, you know, my brothers and sisters, this judgment, I knew that we were going to go through some events before Jesus returned. I am letting the Lord's hour know this because the Lord told me that there were going to be events before he's coming and that the world was going to get worse before he's coming. And that's exactly what we're seeing. Chaos in America, too, with the election fraud. I mean, the list goes on, my brothers and sisters, as you, some of you have probably searched up some of the areas around the world. It all started, remember, September, California and Oregon, wildfires. It was devastated. Unbelievable. I mean, the smoke was from the fires that spread from the west to east. And now Russia, I believe that this was about 2 days ago, I think, or they're having an ice storm so bad that it paralyzed, I believe, the country there. If you see the pictures, it's devastated. It's unbelievable. God is getting our attention. Asian, if you go to Asian, Indonesia is flooded also. I mean, the weather is, see, Russia is a state of an emergency was declared in a large section of eastern Russia late last week. Moscow Times reported at least 150,000 people were without electricity. Get ready. You're in America. Because we can probably get hit too with a big storm, my brothers and sisters. We don't know, but we have to get ready. We have to be ready. Indonesia floods damage hundreds of homes. Damage. I mean, heavy rains and flooding all over the place. And it's just big ones. This is time for repentance, my brothers and sisters. We're in a time of repentance. Repent, therefore, and turn again that your sins, says the Lord, in Acts 3:19, that your sins may be blotted out. Praise you, Jesus. From the time Jesus began to preach, saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Earth is crying out. Earth is letting us know. Devastation here, devastation to the right, to the left, everywhere. And now, as Brother Elby was letting us know, that this year, California, there's the judgment coming towards California. My brothers and sisters, we gotta get right with God, and we have to get our houses in order. I'm exposing evil on Facebook. I don't know. I don't care what people are going to think or say. I'm doing everything possible that I can. You know, we have to expose evil and the things also that is happening around the world. Because we want to get people attention. We need to let people know the truth before we leave Earth. We got to let them know about the vaccine. We need to let them know about why these things are happening around us, around the world, and why is it happening? Why are the elections being frauded? All this. We're going to go home. We need to let people know. Hallelujah. Praise God. May the Lord have mercy and help us to be ready for the rapture, my brothers and sisters. Every day, repent as much as you can and ask Jesus to cleanse your clothes. Matthew 4:17, from that time, Jesus began to preach, saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Is at hand. The Lord is not slow to fulfill his promise. Remember, he's waiting. He was waiting, and he's still waiting at some kind of slowness. But his patience towards you, towards me, towards us, not wishing that any shall perish, but that all shall reach repentance. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And what we need to pray is for our families. We just got to pray to be right with God. We have to humble ourselves. We got to ask Jesus to humble us. We got to ask the Lord to make us more like him. And Peter said to them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins. And you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Praise the living God. The times of ignorance God overlooked, but now he commands all people everywhere to repent. To repent. Earth is crying out. Earth is letting us know, Jesus, hallelujah, your Creator is coming, and we already know that he's getting closer while the church is still asleep. We need to wake up, and we need to warn the others, and we need to let them know what is approaching, what is coming, what is next, what is happening, what's going on. So then when we go and God take us, then at least they knew, and they're going to think about it. Oh, wow. They let us know. They were right. They were letting us know. And then they would know what to do. The people that are going to be left behind, those that, you know, that are going to find out, because you let them know, they're going to say, they're going to realize, wow, she was right. He was right. And we just got to we need to start doing what they told us to do. It's not to do. Praise you, Jesus. We need to confess our sins to Jesus. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Jesus, forgive us, Lord. Forgive us our sins. We have to be humble. We have to give ourselves to Jesus and have a relationship with our Lord and be humble and pray about it. My brothers and sisters, about the judgment that is coming towards California, I remember having a dream, my brothers and sisters, long time ago, that I have let you know in the past that I had this dream when I was even, I think I was even around 7, 8, or 9 months pregnant from my daughter Olivia back then, back in 2000. I had this vision that I was in my bedroom. I was sleeping, and my soul got out of my body, and my soul went to the living room. In the living room, the TV turned on, and then I see all these it was a TV with all this bunch of channels, like CNN, you know, Fox News, ABC, Telemundo, Univision. It was like about maybe 10 or 20 channels all over the place on the TV, letting me know something horrible had happened, something bad. Look at this devastation that just happened. And I'm thinking, oh my goodness, what just happened? What happened? What happened that I didn't know? And I started to watch every single episode, every single news that they were reporting at that time. And I remember very well, because Univision, the director of divisiones, what's this guy's name? Jorge Ramos. And there was another lady there that I forgot her name. She was, he was talking about this, what happened. And I didn't know back then, I didn't know that it was Chicago, but now I know that it's Chicago because the way how he said there is a church in Cicero that is called Sonidos de Alabanza, which means Sonidos de Alabanza, praising. That's the only church that is available to encourage and the people that are in need. If you need prayer, go to this church. If you need encourage, go to this church. This church is still open, and they're welcoming people, for people to go there to get help and prayer or whatever it was. I'm thinking, oh wow, this is Chicago. And now that I'm thinking, after, you know, Brother Elby said that about California, I'm thinking, wow. Back then I was pregnant from Olivia. Olivia's 20 now. She's 20 years old. And we are in the year 2020. You see, 2020. Now, I'm just saying this because this is, I just came up with that conclusion. And I'm thinking, wow, it's like a puzzle. You know, I'm trying to put everything together. And I take it as a confirmation from the Lord that He is letting me know, wow, you know, the devastation, the judgment of California was going to be when your daughter was 20 years old. See, 2020. Remember, my brothers and sisters, I don't know, God is in control. He can do anything. He can do whatever He likes. He's God. God is angry. God is angry. And it's not only angry with America. He's angry with the whole world. Just like the same thing at the days of Noah's, when he was unhappy. He wasn't pleased with humanity. He's not happy with humans right now. What is happening all over the world? It's not only America that is in great sin. No, there's so many countries. There's so many nations, countries, you know, that they're just not pleasing God. It's all over the place. It's all over the place. Honduras, Salvador, Guatemala just got hit really bad. These people, they got no homes. There's thousands and thousands and thousands of them with no home. And there's still people on top of the houses after 1 week of devastation. Because the devastation is so big, some of them have probably already gone with their family members. They lost it all. And now guess what? We're going to be next. You see what's happening? It's happening in Asia. I believe even China, I think it got flooded too. All over the place. Russia, it's time for repentance. It's time for repentance. It's time to reveal. It's time to reveal the truth and expose evil. And warning people for what is about to come. And hallelujah, and run to the Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome, sunshine. Welcome, sister. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, every listener. My brothers and sisters, my dear brothers and sisters, this is serious. This is serious, my brothers and sisters. The time of ignorance God overlooked, but now He commands all people everywhere to repent. Acts 17:30. He wants us to repent, my brothers and sisters. He wants us to humble ourselves. He wants us to say, Lord, I'm so sorry, Jesus. Take it like if you are the one that take it like if it is you, my brothers and sisters. That's how I pray. I pray, Lord, forgive my sins. I forgive my sins. Forgive this land. Forgive us, Lord. Forgive us. We repent. Yes, we want Jesus to come. I want Jesus to come, my brothers and sisters. I want the Lord to come, as all of you guys want the Lord to come too. And we want to get out of here, right? But we got to be right with God. We have to be right with God. If that is your way of thinking, that, because that's the way that I'm thinking, then just say, Lord, cleanse my clothes, cleanse my robes, purify me, Jesus, my soul, my spirit. Lord, I want to be right with you. I don't want to be left behind. I beg you for my soul. Just start begging God for your soul and mercy for your soul and for your loved ones. The King is about to return. And we have to confess our sins. We have to confess them every day. I think that some of us, my brothers and sisters, based on my on my experience, and even my sister Denise, that she's living here in my house, and she moved here. She moved into my house. The Lord brought her here since June, and she experienced something. And I experienced. Well, I'm gonna tell what happened to me just today. When I went to throw some garbage in the containers, I went outside my brothers and sisters, and it was raining, right? It was raining in Chicago this morning, and a couple hours ago it was raining, and I went there. I went outside to dump some garbage, and all of a sudden my brothers and sisters, something that flew close to me, very close. I couldn't see, but I felt the air. I felt the air, my brothers and sisters. I heard the air, and I heard the wings, like that, really strong. And I'm thinking, what was that? And I was looking everywhere. I look right, I look left, and I look up. And I'm thinking, was that a hawk? What was that? And I kept looking on the air. I look on the trees, nothing. I look on the right side, nothing. By the fence, nothing. I look on the floor. I was thinking, was it a big bird that just fell down? And I'm like, wow, what was that? So 2 days ago, I was dreaming that there were many, like a veil in my eyes was opening. There were many, like many doors, one door open and another one and another one. And I'm thinking, oh my goodness, what's going on? This was a dream. Okay? But what happened a couple hours ago was reality. And the reason why I'm saying this is I'm getting to the point. In my dream, I was about to see the unseen. And I'm like, and then I'm looking through my areas that it was, that some of those areas were being open and open and open. And I'm thinking in my dream, I'm thinking this, wow, I'm about to see the unseen. I don't know, my brothers and sisters, that might be the case, maybe not, but that's what happened. And if that's the case, for us to see the unseen, because it happened to Denise too. She was able to see something too. And I'm thinking, could it be that some of us in the last days we're going to be able to see things, so then we can, you know, rebuke them and bind them, and if it's something bad, God is going to allow some of us to see, so we can pray. We can pray about it. I'm telling you, that was something. It was mysterious, and it doesn't surprise me, my brothers and sisters, because we're getting so close. We're getting so close to the judgment. And may the Lord, my brothers and sisters, this God is in control. If God wants to do it, He'll do it. If He wants to stop this, He'll stop this. Depending on how many righteousness are, it depends on how many people are going to pray about it. It depends if people are going to cry out for mercy. Because you know Jesus is always merciful and He intercedes for us. But it all is in God's hands. It's in God's hands. All I can tell you is that I'm just getting ready. Getting my house in order, buying. I keep on buying. Every time I go outside, I buy something. when you go outside, get paper towel, get more food, refill and refill, you know, because every day we consume items, right? And so we need to refill it again. And we have to bear fruit. We got to bear fruit. We got to tell others. We need to tell people about the gospel. And at the same time, we need to confess ourselves. We have to cleanse, ask Jesus to cleanse us and make us righteousness. Amen? And through repentance. And we got to bear fruit. And again, 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people who are called by my name humble themselves, we need to humble ourselves. And pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. Jesus has been letting us know all this year that we need to go through repentance and to humble ourselves. We have to continue doing that. If we do that, God can hold on. He can hold on to the judgment, my brothers and sisters. But it's up to God now. He's in control. Acts 11:18. When they heard these things, they fell silent and they glorified God, saying, then to the Gentiles also God has granted repentance that leads to life. Amen. Repentance leads you to life. Because when we repent, what we're doing is we're being humble, right? We're taking our fault, because we do sin every day. So we're taking our fault and we're saying, Lord, I'm so sorry. I repent, and you and the Holy Spirit is going to reveal you. The Holy Spirit let us know. He let us know what we did wrong, what we were thinking, what we were touching, what did you touch yesterday or today? What did you say today and yesterday? And all these days, and the Holy Spirit gives us a conviction of sin, and the Holy Spirit leads us to repentance, and then repentance, Jesus comes and washes our sins away, so then we become righteousness before God, so then God can hear our prayers. Amen. So that's how it is. That's how it works. That's why it is very important to repent. Luke 13:3. No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. We don't want to perish. If we don't repent, that means we're going to perish. Why? Because we sin every day. And if we don't repent, our sin stays in us. And then when we are praying and asking God to, we're asking God for anything, and we're praying for our family or our friends, we're dirty. We're dirty if we haven't repent. Jesus taught me, my brothers and sisters, that we do need to repent before we start a prayer. The first thing that we do need to do is repentance, and then you go ahead and pray anything about your life, about your family, your friends, about anything. But first has to be repentance. I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repent. Luke 5:32. And we're all sinners. This is not only for the unrighteous people, for those that haven't accepted Jesus as their own Savior. This is for all of us. Revelation 2:5, remember therefore from where you have fallen. Repent and do the works you did at first. If not, I will come to you and remove your lampstand from its place unless you repent. So you see, God is letting us know here. Why is it important to repent? Whoever conceals his transgressions will not prosper, but he who confesses and forsakes them will obtain mercy. So we're going to confess our sins to Jesus. Confess our sins to the Lord. Why am I talking to repentance? And, you know, Sister Carla, you have talked about repentance a lot, because the Lord is letting me know to bring repentance to his people. Because that's what we need. We're going home, my brothers and sisters. We're seeing it everywhere. We're seeing the signs. We're seeing the seasons. We already know. We know that he is approaching and he is so quickly to come. We're seeing it everywhere. God exalted him at his right hand as a leader and savior to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. Acts 5:31. 2 Timothy 2:25, correcting his opponents with gentleness. God may perhaps grant them repentance, leading to a knowledge of the truth. And saying the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Hallelujah. Repent, repent, for the kingdom of God is near. Hallelujah. Praise humility. That's what God wants us. The reward for humility and fear of the Lord is riches and honor and life. People that are younger, those that are younger, be subject to the elders. Clothe yourself, all of you, with humility towards one another, says the word God. For God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Put on them, as God chooses ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Kindness. Practice this. Kindness and your humility, meekness, and patience. Imitate. Do everything. Everything what Jesus did, everything what the Lord does, everything what the Holy Spirit, the gift of the Holy Spirit, everything what he does, we gotta follow them. We have to be like them. But he gives more grace, therefore it says, God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Lord, we have to say, Lord, forgive me for my pride. We have to recognize, my brothers and sisters, we live on earth. We can't say, oh, you know, I don't have pride. I can say that. We all can say that. We all sometimes it just happens that we just say things that are not pleasing to the Lord. So we need to humble ourselves. We need to accept ourselves that we are sinners. And we need to humble ourselves and say, God, Lord, forgive me. Forgive me. Humble myself. Humble myself and remove this pride from me. When pride comes, then comes this grace, says the word of God. But with the humble is wisdom. Proverbs 11:2. With all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love. Bearing with one another in love. And that's exactly what is coming. We're going to have to be bearing ourselves, one another with love, my brothers and sisters, and humility and gentleness. For the things that are approaching, the things that are about to happen, the things that are about to come. Humble ourselves before the Lord and he will exalt you. He will exalt us. James 4:10, the fear of the Lord is instruction in wisdom, and humility comes before honor. So before destruction, a man's heart is haughty, but humility comes before honor. God is good. God is good. And God is very humble. Jesus is very humble, my brothers and sisters. We all know that. The Lord, my goodness, he came to die for us. He was nailed at the cross. And he was humble until death. He has told you, oh man, what is good and what does the Lord require of you but to do justice and to love kindness and to love kindness and to walk humbly, humble with your God. 1 Peter 5:6, humble yourself therefore under the mighty hand of God so that at the proper time he may exalt you. He wants us to humble ourselves. He wants us to pray for that. Lord, humble myself. Tell him, humble myself, Jesus. Help me to be humble just like you. Help me to be more like you, Jesus. If we humble ourselves and we pray and seek his face, and we turn from our wicked ways, then God from heaven will hear and will forgive our sin and our land. Hallelujah. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. Do nothing from, hallelujah, reverently or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourself. And that's what the Lord wants us to do. There's hell and there's heaven. There's heaven and hell. Friends that are listening, Revelation 21:8, but it's for the cowardly, the faithless. Remember, without faith, it is impossible to please God. The faithless, the detestable, is for murderers, the sexually immoral, sorcerers, idolaters, and all liars. Their portion will be in the lake that burns with fire and sulfur, which is the second death. That's hell. I have to tell this to people. Oh, there's no hell. Some people say, oh, there's no hell. If God is a God of mercy, how can hell exist? God didn't make hell for you. He didn't make hell for humans. You might say, well, then why did he send them? No, he didn't send them there. You chose to be sent there. You chose that because you choose your destiny here on earth. You choose heaven or you choose hell, depending on what you did. And if you didn't accept Jesus Christ as your own Savior, but if you were a Christian and you were a hypocrite and you were doing all type of things that you were doing, that you didn't stop doing after giving your life to Jesus, you continue to sin and sin and sin and sin. I'm sorry, that's the destiny. That's your destiny. But there's always hope. Like Jesus told me, there's always hope while you're still here on earth. Repentance, 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 so we can make it to heaven. Matthew 10:28. And do not fear those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. And this will go away into eternal punishment, Matthew 25:46. But the righteous into eternal life. Say, Lord, make me righteous. Make me like you. Lord, forgive my sins. I repent, Jesus. I repent, Lord. Forgive me, Lord. Have mercy on my soul. And the devil who had deceived them was thrown into the lake of fire, that Satan's future, and sulfur, where the beast and the false prophet were. And they will be tormented day and night forever and ever. Revelation 20:10. Satan wants to remind you of your sins, remind him his future. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise. Praise you, Jesus. Because that's the lake of fire is his future for deceiving so many and destroying so many souls. Praise the name, Jesus. Hallelujah. And we have to be sure that our name is found in the book of life, Revelation 20:15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Say, Lord, write my name in the book of life. Forgive my sins. Forgive my sins, Lord. I give my life to you, Jesus. Forgive everything that I have done, everything that I have done, my Lord, since the day that I was born until the last second of the rapture. Forgive me, Lord, and write my name in the book of life. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But I say to you that everyone who's angry with his brother will be liable to judgment. Whoever insults his brother will be liable to the council. And whoever says you fool will be liable to the hell of fire. We have to ask for forgiveness, my brothers and sisters. You got something against your brother, something against your sister, something against your your blood but your brother in Christ or your sister in Christ or even your blood. We have to, hallelujah. We have to say, I'm sorry. Even if it's not our fault, you know why? Because it says on the Word of God, we have to forgive. But I say to you that everyone who's angry with his brother will be liable to judgment. Whoever insults his brother will be liable to counsel. And whoever says you fool will be liable to the hell of fire. The Word of God. The Word of God is serious. It's loving, it's encouragement, it's discipline, but it's also serious, and we have to take it serious because, my brothers and sisters, we have to take it serious because there's heaven and hell. That's why we have to take it serious. Revelation 14:11, and the smoke of their torment goes up forever and ever, and they have no rest day or night. These worshippers of the beast and it is image, and whoever receives the mark of his name. If you, God forbid, you get left behind, doesn't matter if they pull your skin off, your fingers cut off. Oh my goodness. You may think the worst of it. Do not put that mark of the beast, which is going to be a chip. And now, I believe, is what they're doing now with COVID-19, that they're actually placing the chip in there. That's why the Lord doesn't want us to take the COVID-19 vaccine. Don't do it. Whatever it takes, whatever happens, you want to fly home. And if you don't fly home, you're going to have to go through all this torment, tribulation that have never been on earth and never will. You have to go through that to make it to heaven. But I don't want to discourage. I don't want to discourage you. There's hope. There's still hope because we're still here on earth. Still here on earth, so there's still hope for you and me. 2 Thessalonians 1:9, they will suffer the punishment of eternal destruction away from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his might. We can't do anything without God, my brothers and sisters, you know, and friends that are listening. You don't want to be out of the presence of the Lord for eternity. No way. No. You don't want to be in suffering and suffer the punishment of eternal destruction. Friends, run to Jesus. Give your life to the Lord. Time is running out. Can't you see it everywhere? Catastrophe everywhere. Earth is crying out. Earth is already letting us know. Matthew 13:15, and throw them into the fiery furnace, and the place there will be weeping and a snatching of teeth. You know why? Because people down there, or souls down there, what they think is, why you didn't listen? Why was I stubborn? Why was I a fool? Why I didn't listen? Now I'm going to stay here for eternity. That's the weeping and the gnashing of teeth. At the same time, you know, they're just going to punish themselves. Hell is not a good place. Hell is a place of torment and suffering. For if God did not spare angels when they sin, think about this, 2 Peter 2:4. but cast them into hell and committed them to chains of gloomy darkness to be kept until the judgment? He did it to some of the angels. Some of the angels that sinned, disobedience. I have let you know a lot of times, if it's one of the things that God does not like at all, is disobedience. Lord, make me obedient. Tell him, just say, Lord, make me obey you, Jesus. Please, I beg you. I beg you. Beg the Lord right now. Beg him. Ask him. And say, Lord, if I got problems with disobedience, Lord, I pray that you will help me with obedience. Help me, because I don't want to be lost. I don't want to be left behind. I want to be with you, Lord, because without you, I can't make it. You can't make it with the Holy Spirit. You can't. There's no happiness without Jesus and without the Holy Spirit. You are not happy. You can tell me all you want, but it's true. That's a lie. You cannot live without Jesus and the Holy Spirit, because your life without Jesus and the Holy Spirit is miserable. That's why some people going through depression, suicide, they kill themselves, because they can't take that, and they do their own judgment on the things that they do. That's why it is so important to give your life to Jesus and have the Holy Spirit with you right now at this moment. And this time of life right now that everything is going all over the place. Just as Sodom and Gomorrah and the surrounding cities, which likewise indulge in sexual immorality and pursue a natural desire, serve as an example by undergoing a punishment of eternal fire. God likes this homosexuality? No, God didn't make you like that. Nonsense. He didn't make you like that. That's a lie from hell. God made a woman, a man and a woman. Adam and Eve. He didn't make Adam and Adam. He didn't make you and Eve. That's a lie from hell. Repent. If you've got problems with that, if you're a homosexual, God loves you, but he hates your sin. Give your life to Jesus and say, Lord, deliver me. Deliver me tonight. I pray that you will write my name in the book of life. Don't say that, oh, because you have done that great sin before God, that you're going to go to hell. No, there's hope. There's hope. You're still here on earth. There's still hope. Don't judge yourself. Don't do that to yourself. Give your life to Jesus and say, I repent, Lord. Please forgive me. Wash my sins away with your holy, mighty blood. And say to the Lord, deliver me, and fast, pray and fast. Read His holy word. That His holy word is honey to your lips. It's gonna be honey to your lips. It's gonna fulfill your soul. No one can fulfill your soul more than the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit and Jesus are the ones who are gonna fulfill your soul. No one, not your husband, not your wife, not your kids. No one can fulfill that in your soul except for the Holy Spirit. It's the one that gives you happiness and joy and peace and everything that you do need. And that's why we resist. That's why we embrace ourselves. That's why we have a strength, because it's all coming from the Holy Spirit. We are embracing ourselves from all this that is happening. Embrace ourselves. Only the Holy Spirit can help us with that. And we're making it because the Holy Spirit is helping us. Now think about that, you friends, that you haven't given your life to Jesus. When you give your life to Jesus, the Holy Spirit comes and dwells in you, in your body, because our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. So when you give your life to Jesus, the Holy Spirit comes to you. And then you're going to realize, you're going to say, oh my goodness, what was I thinking? Why I didn't give my life to Jesus? This is awesome. I love him. He's good. And you're going to start feeling refreshed. You're going to start feeling light, because all those sins all the baggage that you got is gonna go away because Jesus is gonna take care of that. Jesus is gonna cleanse you with His holy blood. The Holy Spirit comes to dwell in you, and the Holy Spirit is gonna help you from day one, from all continuously, every single day. John 3:16-18. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world. He didn't come here to condemn you. He didn't come here to condemn the world just because of your sin. He came here to save us. But in order that the world might be saved through Him, whoever believes in Him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe is condemned already. Because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And that's John 3:16-18. Read the Word of God and it's going to set you free. You're going to say, wow, I have been gone through all these churches, all these religions. All these religious things everywhere. Just read the Word of God. COVID happened also for a reason, so the churches can be closed because nobody talks about heaven. Nobody talks about hell anymore. Nobody's talking about the return of Jesus. Nobody's telling people about, you know, to repent from their sins. No, there's no pastors that were saying that. Barely some of them. Well, God is instructing us now in the house. God and the Holy Spirit, God and Jesus, hallelujah, the Holy Spirit is the one who's helping us now in the house, in our daily basis, because He's awesome, He's good, He doesn't want us to be lost. He says, enough is enough with this, enough. I'm instructing my people in their homes. I'm going to do it. That's what God is doing. I'm going to do it. No more false teaching. No more of this, no more of that. But God Himself is instructing you in your home, reading the Word. God and the Holy Spirit, which is a beautiful thing, is instructing you in your own home. It's teaching you. Isn't that awesome? That's beautiful. Hallelujah. And if your hand causes you to sin, Mark 9:43-48, cut it off. It is better to you to enter life crippled than with two hands to go to hell, to the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It's better to you to enter life lame than with two feet to be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to sin, tear it out. This doesn't mean that you're gonna have to tear your eye out and cut your legs and cut your hand off. It's talking about spiritually. It's talking about your sin. Your eye, if you're watching, let's say, I'm going to give you an example, if you're watching porno, then tear it out means you have to break that. You have to depart yourself from that. You have to ask repentance, you know, and ask Jesus to cleanse you and no more of that. And you black that area. You put something else, and what you're going to do, you're going to lock your phone, you're going to lock your computer, that those things are not allowed in your house. That's blocking yourself out. That's actually telling your eye, no, I'm not giving you permission, and I'm not going to allow you to watch this crap anymore. You're not. It's better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than with two eyes to be thrown in hell. Where the worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. So throw that garbage out. Throw it out. Hell is real. Hell is real. Praise you, Jesus. But we're here. We're still here. There's hope. There's hope. Because we're still here on earth. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. If you have touched something that you do know that is not pleased, then you're going to hold on, then you're not going to touch that again. You're not going to touch that again, and you're going to say, no, not anymore. Whatever it is, only you and God knows. Cut it off means no more. No more. Not again. Let me just try it one more time. No more. Cut it off, it means no more. You're putting a stop right there. But not touching that. And again, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Give your life to Jesus, friend, that you're listening. Just say, I give my life to you, Jesus. I am so sorry. Forgive my sins. Cleanse me. Write my name in the book of life. Don't put so much guilt in your mind, in your brain. That's Satan who does that. Satan is a destructor. That's what he does. He just puts that blame on you. Don't let them do that. No. Because God, when you repent, God forgives you. When you repent, God forgives you. And he sees that sin no more, and he erased that sin. He doesn't remember. He does not longer, no longer remembers that sin no more. That's who God is. That's why God is good. But it's so easy. All we need to do is come into repentance and ask God to forgive us. Daniel 12:2. And many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life and some to shame and everlasting contempt. That's why it's important to give yourself to Jesus. Luke 16:23. And in Hades, being in torment, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. This was a rich person back then that died and went to hell. And he lifted his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. Lazarus was poor. And we all know the story. But for the friends that are listening, this was a rich man that he didn't feel pity for Lazarus. He just threw his leftovers. And Lazarus, back then he was poor. And he didn't care about him. So when Lazarus died, he went to heaven. When the rich person died, he went to hell. And then when he was in hell, he was asking Abraham to put a little bit, just one single drop of water on his tongue. And people that are over there are already there, they can't come. And people that are in hell, they can't go up there. So it was too late for him. It was too late. And that's reality. That's reality. Hell and heaven are real. But I will warn you whom to fear. Fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast into hell. Luke 12:5. Yes, I tell you, fear him. You better fear God. It's a good fear. And the fear means honor him. In obedience towards him. It's not a fear, the same fear that you feel for Satan. That's totally different. And we should not be afraid of Satan. We should not be afraid of demons, because God has gave us authority to fight He has given us authority. And we do need to know and learn the good fight. Amen. Because we are His church, we are His children. And we do need to know when these things come. We do need to know, hallelujah, how to fight in Jesus' name. We're not doing it with our own bodies. Nope. We're doing it with Jesus. Jesus' strength. Without Jesus, we can't fight. When you're being attacked by a demon, you know what to do. I rebuke you in Jesus' name, bind you in Jesus' name, break your powers by the blood of Jesus, and send you to the pit of hell. And if it's Satan, you say, Lord, may the Lord Jesus Christ rebuke you, Satan. And God helps you in the Holy Spirit. Call up on the Holy Spirit, too. Holy Spirit, come down with fire and power all over this place and exterminate them. And there you go. That's all you need. When the enemy knows that you know how to fight, they will not want nothing to do with you. In fact, they're going to be afraid of you. But if you are afraid of them, they know that. They're like hyenas. They can smell you. They know. They study you. And they know that if you are afraid of them. And Jesus doesn't want you to be afraid of them, because he has given you authority to fight. Matthew 5:30. And if your right hand causes you to sin, I'm sorry, I already read that. Hebrews 9:27, if you go before the rapture, and just as it is appointed for men to die once, and after that comes judgment. Amen. God is the one who judges us. He's the one who judges us, my brothers and sisters and friends that are listening. We die once, and after that comes judgment. As soon as you die, you either go to heaven or you go to hell. And the reason that you, if someone, let's say, someone goes, right, goes to hell, it's because he's already been judged. So when you come out of your body, you're going to go to either place, heaven or hell. That's why Hebrews 9:27 says, and just as it is appointed for men to die once, and after that comes judgment. That's why it's important, very important, to be with Jesus. Very important. Because we don't know when are we going to die. Only God, the Father, knows. He's the one who destined our life. He's the one who takes our life, gives our life, and takes our life. So He's the only one. If I got the Father, is the only one who knows your numbers and when is your day. So that's why we gotta be ready at all times, because we don't know when that day is gonna be. We don't know if it's going to be today. We don't know if it's going to be tomorrow. We don't know if it's going to be before the rapture. If it's we don't know. Or if it's going to be before the rapture. God is going to take a lot of them before the rapture happens. Through the events, He's going to take some of them. So we better be ready. We don't know. If it's going to be you, it's going to be me. We don't know. Only God knows. Only God knows. And that's the reason why we got to be ready. We should not let our guard down. We always, and how can we be ready? Asking for forgiveness. Lord, I repent. I repent. Cleanse my sins. Wash my sins away. Purify my soul, my mind, my conscience, everything about me from head to toe. Cleanse me. I want to be right with you. And help me. Help me to obey you. And I just humble myself, Lord. I humble myself to you. And I give my life to you. And Lord, only you know when are you going to take me. If I die tonight, My Lord, I pray that I beg you mercy for my soul. I beg you mercy for my soul. Forgive me from everything that I have done, that I have said, that I have touched. Everything, please. I'm so sorry. Forgive me. I repent. And at least, I mean, if it happens tonight, at least you are right with God. You went to repentance. And if it happens that night, guess what? You die, you go to heaven. Matthew 16:18. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. You see? The gates of hell will not prevail against you. God have built a church in you like a rock. We have to spread the gospel. We have to let people know what's going on. We need to let them know about Jesus. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. Whoever does not obey the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God remains on him. John 3:36. It's serious, my brothers and sisters. The word of God is beautiful. It's loving. It gives you encouragement, but also warns you, and it lets you know the things that you are not and things that you are supposed to do. Psalm 16:10, for you will not abandon my soul to Seol, or let your Holy One see corruption. The wicked shall return to Seol, all the nations that forget God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Jesus. Praise your name. And now we're going to talk about heaven. He will wipe away every tear from your eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, for the former things have passed away. Revelation 21:4. God takes us home. It's not going to be tears. No more crying. No more death. You can't die. You're already there. You're not going to be sad anymore. No more crying. No more pain. And all those things have passed away. Everything that you went through here on earth, everything will pass away. You're not going to be longer suffering, but just to do eternal joy and peace with God, the Father, the Holy Spirit, and the Son. If my Father's house are many rooms, says the word of God in John 14:2. If we're not so, will I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? But it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the heart of man imagined, what God has prepared for those who love him. God has prepared your beautiful home the way you like it, your taste. And you deserve it because you did everything. You did it all for him. You couldn't live without Jesus. Yes, you know, we're humans and we tried our best, but you did try. And you give it all for Jesus. You gave it all for the Lord. Now he's going to give you what you deserve in heaven. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. Hallelujah. And that's the meaning of life, Jesus. So you will not perish. You have to believe in Jesus Christ, that he's the Son of God. Because if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes and it's justified. So you believe in your heart. And with the mouth, one confesses, you're going to confess. You're going to say, Jesus, I accept you as my own Savior. And you're going to be saved. For the scripture says, everyone who believes in him will not be put to shame. You're not going to be put to shame because you're not going to go to hell. You're going to be in eternity in heaven with him forever and ever, eternity beyond. For there's no distinction between Jew and Greek. For the same Lord is Lord of all, bestowing his riches on all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Hallelujah. And he said to him, truly, I say to you today, you will be with me in paradise. That's what he told the man that was next to him. Father, remember me when you go to paradise. And the Lord said immediately right there, truly, I say to you. Why? Because he believed that he said it. See, he believed that he was the Son of God, and he said it with his mouth. Remember me when you go to remember me when you be in paradise. And the Lord said it right there, right there. Luke 23:43, and he said to him, truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. That's awesome. Whew. What a blessing for that guy, huh? It's the same thing with you. You say it with your mouth. You believe in your heart, and then you confess it with your mouth, and you believe that Jesus is the Son of God. If you die tonight, you will go to paradise in your future. That's what it's going to take you to Jesus. Do not lay out for yourself treasures on earth. Forget about earth, my brothers and sisters. Forget about putting treasures in here. Where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break and steal. But lay up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. So your treasure should be heaven. Shall be heaven. And that's where your heart is going to be also. Your heart is going also to be in heaven. But as it is, they desire a better country that is a heavenly one, Hebrews 11:16. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared for them a city. God has prepared so many beautiful things in heaven for you that you're going to be with your mouth dropped. We have no idea. We can't comprehend. We cannot even imagine. We can imagine, but we cannot even... we can't comprehend the beauty of God. The knowledge of God is beyond our comprehension, our knowledge. Mm-mm. And that's why it's awesome still to follow him and to be with him, because we know we have a very secure future. Very secure future, and that's heaven, being with Jesus. Revelation 21:22-27, and this is the future. And I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb. And the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gives its light, and its lamp is the lamp. By its light will be nations walk. And the kings of the earth will bring their glory into it. And its gates will never be shut by day. And there will be no night there. That's heaven. They will be into it, the glory and the honor of the nations. It's beautiful in the millennium too. The New Jerusalem. That's our future, my brothers and sisters. That's our future, friends that are listening. That's why it is so important to give your life to Jesus, because there's so much that you don't know that you're going to know by reading the Word of God. Revelation 21:21-25, and hallelujah, and the 12 gates were 12 pearls, each of the gates made of a single pearl. listen, this is heaven, listen to this. And the street of the city was pure gold, transparent as glass. And I saw no temple in the city, for it is temple is the Lord God, the Almighty and the Lamb. And the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it. For the glory of God gives it light. Think about that. And it is lamp. It is the lamb. By it is light will the nations walk. And the kings of the earth will bring their glory into it. And its gates will never be shut by day. And there will be no night there. So there's no night in heaven. There's always light because God is light. And that's why when you believe in Jesus Christ as his own, as your own Savior, you become light. You are light of the darkness. Because God is light. By according to his promise, we are waiting for new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. That's the millennium, 2 Peter 3:13. You see, the future continues and continues. There's always something new with God. We're going to learn so much. And you know, it's going to be perfect because we are going to know from the King. He's the one who's going to teach us. Praise God. No more man here teaching us, but just, you know, Jesus himself. He's going to be a rabbi. No more false teaching. No more of this and that, but just pure teaching. Holy teaching from the word, from the mouth of our beautiful King Jesus. No one has ascended into heaven except he who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. John 3:13. See, Jesus came. He descended from heaven and he gave his life for you and me. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. My friends are listening. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My sister's asking me, hallelujah. Are you if I'm a female, yes, I am a sister in Christ. I am a female. I'm sorry. My voice sometimes gets deep when it's really cold. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. God is good. God is good. My God, my sister. I tried to put my picture there, my brother and sister, for some reason. I'm looking in the chat room right now, and it's not showing anything. I try so much. I'm putting my picture there. You can see my picture on Facebook, and then you're gonna find out who am I. I don't put pictures about myself. I just put. I do have the dove. And trumpet, because I know that Jesus is coming and he's coming quickly. So I just put a new picture there of the trumpet on Facebook. I do have sunshine. I do have some of my brothers and sisters in on Facebook. And you can find me by Carla Ott. And then you'll see, I don't know, for some reason it doesn't want to show here in the chat room. I try to paste that picture there, but it's not happening. So I don't know what's going on. Praise you, Jesus. With all these things that are doing to us on Facebook, that, we're losing our freedom, brothers and sisters. We have to pray. We got to pray. We have to pray for this country. Continue to pray, my brothers and sisters. There's nothing impossible for God. There's nothing impossible, my brothers and sisters. Maybe, you know, this is what I'm thinking, my brothers and sisters. I could be wrong, but this is just me thinking. I'm just thinking, my brothers and sisters, that this election happened like this for a reason. It got fraud, right? All of us know, big time. And I think it happened for a reason, so God can expose the evil about this country. He's going to reveal the truth. Now, I'm just saying it. I'm just thinking like this. Because, and then, you know, a lot of people are going to find out. And God is in control, my brothers and sisters. Let's say if President Donald Trump wins in December 14th, then praise God, because there's so many things that are going to stop if he wins, including our freedom and everything. But if that is not the case, then we just already know that that's the reason why we're getting ready. Amen. For whatever happens, the Lord have not revealed to me anything yet about what is going to happen. But I just feel it, that I really feel, my brothers and sisters, that, you know, evil is going to be exposed, and we're going to know the truth. And if it wins, either Donald Trump wins or Biden, it's going to be, I really think it's going to be a chaos. You know, hopefully we don't have to go through civil war, because some people, the left or the right, are just going to go, they're going to go nuts, depending on who wins. Either way, it's just going to be, it's already happening. We're seeing so many things, like, you know, Antifa. Like, I don't want to go through politics right now, because I'm preaching the word of God. But my brothers and sisters, just pray. Pray about it. I know that God wasn't happy with what he did with Jerusalem. I believe that he, President Trump, I believe he signed and divided the land, and he wasn't happy about that one. And it could be the COVID-19 vaccine too. But either way is bad, my brother and sister, because, you know, with Biden it's even worse. I mean, unbelievable. So many things. But I don't know so much about politics. I know about the word of God, so we're just gonna stay here talking about Jesus, amen. It's in God's hands. It's in God's hands. God is in control, and he knows exactly what he's going to be doing, my brothers and sisters. He's coming. That's what we need to think is, what we need to do, my brothers and sisters, is get our house in order. We need to get our house in order. Tell your kids, talk to your kids. Excuse me, talk to your friends. Let them know about Jesus and about the things that are coming. And I know that some of you have already, you know, done it, and what you get is persecution instead from your family, and you just don't even want to talk about it anymore. Listen, if you have done your part, my dear brothers and sisters, if you have done your part, you don't have to worry about it, because you already did it. You already have warned them. You already have let them know about Jesus and about what is about to happen, what is coming. You have, if you have already have done that, then their blood is not going to be in your hands, and you're right with God. If you have done that, then God is in control, and God is he's the one who's going to help you in that area and help you with your family. And if that's not the case, if you haven't learned, there's still time to do it. don't waste any more time. There's still time to do it, and just warn the people and let them know. Amen. And I know it's hard. Some people are so shy that they don't want to say anything because they don't want to, you don't want to be seen by other people or thinking this way, like, I don't know what she's going to think of me, what he's going to think of me after I say this, because I don't want them to think I'm not. So don't think like that. Remember, we can't be ashamed of the gospel, or Jesus is going to be ashamed of you later. Then you don't want that. You don't want that. You do need to let them know, because when this thing happens, guess what? They're going to say, wow, she was right. He was right. I should have done it. And then it's just going to be their fault, but it's not going to be on you. Things are happening everywhere. It's very sad, my brothers and sisters, to see. I'm from Honduras, Central America. It's very sad to see my country underwater. Half of it. It's Central America, in the center of Honduras, right in the middle of the map. If you see the map of Honduras, like right in the middle, from the middle all the way down south, is where everything got underwater. I mean, everything. And God is so good, my brothers and sisters. I asked God, I said, when that hurricane was going there, God revealed it to me. He revealed the flood many months ago before my mom died. I remember he revealed that, he gave me that dream 2 weeks before my mom died. I had a dream that, I saw Honduras flooded with water. And I'm thinking, oh my goodness, this is not good. And I even told my mom. And a couple months later, you know, it happened. But I was asking God, when that hurricane was going to Honduras, I was begging God. I was saying, Lord, please, please don't take that hurricane to the ocean. But if that's not going to be the case, because your judgment has already come, then I ask if you could please, Lord, protect my land, because I do have a land in Honduras, and I don't want that hurricane to destroy my land and the people, the children, and I know some people over there that I didn't want them to get hurt. My brothers and sisters, the hurricane got twisted to the other side, and I even called. I called Honduras, and I called somebody that it was right there close where my land was, and my land wasn't touched. And the people that were living there, they didn't, they only got some, you know, a little bit flooded, but not a lot, just a little bit of the water. But where it got more damaged was towards the south. And I'm like, wow. So God is amazing. God is awesome. You know, when we pray to God, brothers and sisters, and we ask God with all of our heart, He answers our prayers. And He does. He's good. He's good. And we just have to have faith, my brothers. Just have faith. Listen, I'm no better than no one. I'm not special. God chose me because of His mercy. Because He felt mercy for me, my brothers and sisters. I'm no better than no one. No better. No. I pray just like you prayed. I pray to God and I beg the Lord for mercy for my soul, my brothers and sisters. And I humble myself and I say, Lord, I am so sorry, Jesus. I repent. Because we're not, my brothers and sisters, we all make mistakes. We all sin. I'm a human being and we all make mistakes and we all sin. Okay? And we're all the same. We're all the same. God sees us all the same. He loves us. He loves his children. It's like you loving your kids. He just doesn't like, and he doesn't, you know, he's not pleased with sometimes, you know, that we do something wrong, and we sin. Yeah, he doesn't like that. But but that, you know, we ask for forgiveness, and He's going to forgive us, because He's also a loving God and merciful God. We have to take things serious. Yes, we have to take, you know, heaven and hell serious, because it is written, it is in the Word of God. Amen. And so we have to be vigilant, and we gotta pray, and we have to humble ourselves, and we have to be followers of Jesus, and we have to give an example, my brothers and sisters, because if you're not doing a good example, you know, how can they believe the Word of God on you, spreading the gospel? So you have to be a model. You have to be a good example, so then people can come to Jesus. Amen. But if you're preaching the Word of God, and then in your house you're another person, then that is worthless. But just, you know, you're doing your best. You give your life to Jesus. Your life to Jesus. And you're following Jesus, and you're reading the Word of God, and you're fasting, and you're praying, and you're just doing your best. My brothers and sisters, God is not going to kick you out, and He's going to say you're not good enough, and you're a loser. No, 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 no. He's going to take you, and He's going to take you to heaven, because you have tried your best, what you got, your best, and you're doing it every day. And that doesn't mean that you're not, you know, you're not going to sin. We sin every day. But that's okay. We ask for repentance. We pray, and God forgives us. Amen. And we have to continue forward. We have to continue. Don't, when God rebukes you, don't go into your eggshell and just into depression and be in your room and cry about it and say, you know, I'm not good enough. I'm not worth it. I don't know what's going on with me. I can't get it. And I don't know why I am this way and why I keep on falling and blah, blah, blah. That's the enemy. That's the enemy. Okay? When you feel that way, no. You gotta ask forgiveness, you cry about it, and you continue with your life. You ask forgiveness, Jesus forgives you, and Jesus erased that sin away, and you have to continue with your life. Life goes on, and you have to continue. Don't let Satan, do not let that enemy get your brain, you know, your head. Because that's what he does. He's good at that. He's good at playing with your brain. And that's the number one thing. What the enemy does, he's studying. He's studying. So don't let him do that. And so how can you stop that? Through prayer. The Word of God tells us, pray without ceasing. You have to pray to avoid temptation. Hallelujah. Amen. The sunshine says, He can't conquer you when you get back up. Jesus is our strength. Beautiful. Beautiful. That's the mentality that you do have to have. Always positive, my brothers and sisters. Always positive. When he comes and puts thoughts, bad thoughts and negative thoughts in your mind, remind him his future and say, you are going to the lake of fire and I can't wait to see you burning because you are going to heaven. Amen? We are going to heaven. He's going to hell. That's his future. Our future is positive. It's beautiful. Hallelujah. It's awesome. Amen? His future is the lake of fire. So whenever he puts a negative thought in you, I want to remind you, Satan, that the lake of fire is your future. And may the Lord Jesus Christ rebuke you, Satan. And when you say that, my brothers and sisters, Jesus comes immediately and seconds and deals with it. So you don't worry about anything. Just keep your eyes on Jesus. Focus on the Lord. Continue to walk, my brothers and sisters. It's not going to be easy, okay? But hang in there. God is with us, and who can be against us when He is with us? The Holy Spirit is on our side. Jesus is on our side. God the Father. God the Father wants us to be home, and praise God for that. Whatever happens, now God is in control, and whatever happens, it happens. And we have to deal with it. Okay, we have to embrace ourselves. That doesn't mean that, you know, when we see events coming or events happening, my brothers and sisters, we're not going to go, oh my goodness, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? No, that's the time to pray, and that's the time to say, Jesus, give me strength. Holy Spirit gives me strength. And give me peace in the middle of chaos. We got the Holy Spirit because He dwells on us. We have the Holy Spirit, and we have Jesus, and we got angels already. Every one of you, you know, got angels in your house. Father God already sent His angels. You got angels, and if you can pray about it, you can say, Father God, I prayed in Jesus' name that if you could please send me archangels from your holy throne to guard my house, inside and outside. Are my family in Jesus' name. And it's done. As soon as you are done saying that, it already happened. It already happened just in seconds, just like that. I'm telling you from my own experience. That's what my mom told me before she went home. As soon as I prayed that, she was already seeing it. Boom! In seconds. You just say, you know, Father God, empower my faith. Empower my faith so you can draw on His faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. God wants us to have faith. And He doesn't want us to be afraid, brothers and sisters. He doesn't want us. He wants us to be brave. He wants us to be positive. And He wants us to be strong. He wants us to obey Him. He wants us to spread that beautiful gospel. And all those things, that's what He wants. That's all He wants from us, and repentance, obedience. That's not too much. Look, it's not easy to follow Jesus, but it's not impossible. It's not difficult. If He did it in a human form. Did it that way, so we will not have any excuse. Oh, but you never came to earth, so how will you know? Oh, I went through this and I went through that. And I experienced this and I experienced that. We have no excuse to give it to the Father, because He's going to say, oh, it's my son. I sent my son and he went through the same thing like you. Jesus went through trouble when He was here on earth. We all know His story. We can say, well, yeah, but He was God. No, but He wasn't a human form too. Remember that. And He was tempted. And God the Father sent us too. We're here. We're in a human form. And we have to be strong. We've got to please God. And if we fail, yeah, we're going to fail. We all fail. We all have failed. We all have fallen short of the grace of God. We all have done it. We have to be truthful to ourselves. We all have done it. But what do? We repent, we stand up, and we continue to fight the good fight. We continue. You know why it is so easy to go to heaven from here? Because we struggle on earth. Look, on earth we got problems, we got events, tribulations. I mean, all this chaos that is happening on earth, and we're seeing all this evil and all this nonsense and all this politics and all this and that, and flooded everywhere, and hurricanes here, and demons here on earth, and Satan here on earth. Can you imagine? We got to deal with all this. And that's why it's easy for us to make it to heaven, but it's more difficult if you go to the valley, because see, in the valley, what are you going to do? If you go to First Heaven, if you go to Bali, to the Bali, see, the sacrifice is not as big as earth. That's why it's faster and it's easier for us to make it to third heaven, because earth is, whoa. Whew, praise God that he sends us to earth so we can make it to third heaven. And that's what we got to do. Look, we have to conquer. We have to conquer heaven. We have to be brave. The brave is the one who conquers their heaven, the brave ones. We can't be cowards. We have to be strong. Amen? And if we don't have that strength, we ask Jesus, Jesus, help me to be strong. What's the matter with me? What's wrong with me? And also, if you're weak, when you're weak, you're strong. We can't let the enemy put bad negative thoughts in our mind. We can't let that happen. He's a loser. He's already dead. He's going to go to lake of fire. Don't listen to him. You have a future and a beautiful life ahead of you. You're going to be with Jesus. You're going to be with God. You're going to be the Holy Spirit. And that's okay. Hey, if we got to go through this, we have to go through. If we have to go through trouble, we got to go through this and this and this and that and events and more things coming up. That's okay. We'll take it. Because Jesus took it all for you and me. And if he did it, we have to do it too for him. We got to please God. We got to please Jesus. And we have to take things positive. View it that way. Continue. Like a soldier. It's like a soldier. This life is like a soldier. You know, you're going to struggle. Oh my goodness, it's going to kill you. Or you're going to kill. And then the soldier continues with, you know, on his mission. And continues with his mission. Doesn't give up. And then if a friend gets shot, a soldier gets shot, he never lets a soldier behind. He goes back and bring his friends with him and continue with his mission, right? Life is the same way. You have to continue with a good fight until you get to the end line. Until you get to the end. And then Jesus is going to tell you, good servant, well done. Well done. And he's going to put the crown of life on your head. He's going to say, well done, my truthful servant. Well done. Well done. Welcome to my paradise. Welcome to this beautiful place. Look, check it out. Look at everything what I make for you. You know why I make this for you? Because I love you. Because I want to be with you. I created you because I wanted to be a friend with you. And look, you made it. Welcome home, son. Welcome, son. Welcome home, daughter. I love you. Enjoy my paradise. Struggle on earth, but it's worth it at the end. The reward is worth it. The reward is worth it. Your reward is Jesus. Your reward is having. Your reward is Father God. Your reward is Holy Spirit. My goodness, if we can only see the unseen, I think, you know, yes, it would be easier for us, but then we will not have faith. See, sometimes we can't see the unseen because that's how we empower our faith. Because we please God with our faith. So we have to push ourselves and every day and don't let anybody or nobody to get you down. Okay? My brothers and sisters, God bless you. Hallelujah. Yes, we're warriors. We're warriors. Sunshine. Amen. Lord Jesus. And your warrior angels from the north, south, east, and west. Amen. Praise God. In Jesus' name, and it'll be done. May God bless you. And God willing, until next Wednesday, my brothers and sisters, may God shine his face upon you and give you his shalom, give you his peace, and be with you all the days of our life. May God bless you, my brothers and sisters. Shalom, shalom. And focus on Jesus, okay? Focus on the Lord. Give your life to Jesus, friends that are listening. And put your eyes on Jesus, amen? God bless you. God bless you. Shalom, shalom.
My name is Mike, and in today's video, I have an interesting word to share from the 44 Prophecy News site called I Asked, Will Trump or Biden Become President? And it was posted on the 15th of November by Servant. This is how it begins. The Lord spoke the following words on 11/13/20 and 11/15/20 during prayer. This is how it begins. I woke you up to speak on the things about to take place against the human race. As the days grow darker day by day, look to me for what to do and say. The powers that be will continue to strip away your freedoms and liberties in efforts to manipulate and control you. Very soon all things will change at noon. Trump is not who you think he is and no longer lives. For what you see is not of my seed, but the new breed. Biden is also not of me and from Satan's seed. They both have changed their DNA and are instructed on what to do and say. The Lord brought me back to mind words he spoke previously. They are all birds of a feather that flock together. I then asked, will Trump or Biden become president? And if so, which one? Lord responded, neither one will become president due to the meteorites and asteroids that will become evident. Chaos and destruction will fill your land, and men will fall to their knees and weep over what they see. You must come to me for truth, or else you will become aloof. And that's the end of the message. So that's quite an interesting message there. And I want to go to a scripture, Amos 8:9, about noon, darkness at noon. Amos 8:9 says, it will come about in that day, declares the Lord God, that I will make the sun go down at noon and make the earth dark in broad daylight. Right, I'll leave it there and say, anyone out there who hasn't come to Lord Jesus, please do so in prayer of repentance. God bless you all. Bye.
Hi everyone, I'm Melissa with Midnight Hour Oil. I wanted to come out real quickly and just share with you a dream I was given a few months ago. Just remind you, I had shared this dream back when I had it, and I just listened to Dana Coverstone's recent dream that he posted today, and I could see where the Lord had shown me the same thing that he is showing Dana right now. And I was shown in this dream was just, again, you know, we were being locked down. I saw all these politicians, and they were just kind of gathered together, talking, laughing, and I confronted them. I was angry. They had sold America down the river, and I was confronting them for that, basically telling them they would be answerable to God for what they had done. And as I walked away, I said, America is no more. America is no more. And so when I listened to Dana's dream, and again, he explains this, but our dreams are symbolic, and he was shown President Lincoln being basically accused of a crime worthy of death. And I'll just go ahead and attach that to this video so you can listen to Dana share the dream. But it's pretty self-explanatory. Lincoln is symbolic. He is the icon of freedom in America. He is the icon of just the roots of America coming into a place of unity, all right, and freedom. That's what he would be most remembered for. And that's what we see right now being destroyed before our very eyes. And regardless of how things come out with the election, as the church, all right, we have to look at things from God's perspective. And, you know, whether or not things pan out the way we think they will or hope they will, I'm not the type of person who believes that we are going to see prosperity in this nation 10, 20, 30 years down the road. I just don't see, that's not what God is showing me. That's why I share the videos, the dreams other people are having that bear witness with my spirit, because what I see is America coming to an end. And that's a part of biblical prophecy, I believe, in order for things to unfold concerning Israel that will have to unfold. And I just don't see the church being here a whole lot longer. And that's why I keep sharing videos concerning our blessed hope, because church, I really believe that our days here are numbered. And it's important to remember concerning the rapture, the escape, that we receive everything we receive in the kingdom of God by faith. We receive salvation by faith. We receive healing by faith. The rapture, this escape, will, from all of the tribulation, will be no different. It is a promise, and it is something we have to trust the Lord for. And if you're not believing that Jesus is going to fulfill that promise, then just like Maurice Scholar said in his word that he received from Jesus has no obligation to take people out of here that don't believe he's going to do so. So I hope you'll take time to research these things and really understand what the Word of God says concerning the rapture of the church, which is bedrocked in Scripture. I have videos that I have posted about it, you know, the pre-tribulation rapture. I encourage you to take time to watch those, or others who have been given revelation concerning our blessed hope. It is coming, church. It is. Hold on. As always, it is my prayer that we will all continue to keep our lamp burning bright while we wait for Jesus. I love you all. God bless you.
On November 9, 2020, I saw Abraham Lincoln at the Lincoln Memorial, and he was standing up at his feet with his right hand held up and was being addressed by Uncle Sam. There were spotlights aimed at his head, and he was bathed in like this overwhelming light. And on the granite seat where he'd been sitting was a stack of law books, and on the bottom was a simple brown leather rawhide Bible that was larger and thicker than any of the other law books on top. His top hat, the hat that Lincoln was known for using, was sitting on top of the law books, and it kind of made the stack look like a pyramid. Uncle Sam asked him if he would tell the truth, the whole truth, so help him God, and Lincoln said, "That is all you will get from me on this day." Uncle Sam walked backwards without turning around, and he stepped up onto a platform and removed his patriotic hat, and he whispered the words, "I am sorry," towards Lincoln. Then he shifted his eyes to his right and left, and then to the right again, as if he were getting acknowledgement from the people behind him. A voice shouted very loudly, "Get it over with already." And then a hand appeared and pulled the curtain along a piece of rope that appeared to be about 50 feet long, so just pulling a rope like this. And this made it appear as if the judge were standing in front of a large black backdrop, and on each side, hanging like almost like a banner waving down, was a tattered American flag on a pole. Lincoln remained standing as if he had never considered even sitting on the seat. There were marks on his face like he'd been assaulted. He had a sling over his left arm and a bandage around his left hand with the blood showing through the palm. And he kept a very stern face and was obviously in slight pain from whatever had happened. Uncle Sam cleared his throat three times, and then he said, "Hear ye, hear ye. The accused before you is here to admit his crimes publicly and will do so voluntarily. How do you plead, Mr. Lincoln?" Not President, but Mr. Lincoln. The President never blinked his eyes. He swallowed hard and he said, "I won't." Uncle Sam winked at the President and asked again while grimacing in a way to get Lincoln's attention. "I won't" was repeated, and Uncle Sam looked back above and beyond the curtain behind him and then looked back wearily. "Mr. Lincoln, you must make a plea." But Lincoln responded by saying, "Well then, give me a trial by jury after I do." Lincoln simply looked straight ahead and said nothing. Two men then walked up behind Uncle Sam. Each went to a side, and they whispered in both of his ears. And Uncle Sam grimaced, and he dropped his head as the two men went back behind the curtain. Uncle Sam then stood before Lincoln and the crowd of people who had appeared near the chair at the memorial. And this crowd was aggressive, mean-spirited. They held signs, and specifically they had torches in their hands. Lincoln stood taller and closed his eyes slowly after looking both to his right and his left, and of each of the men who stood behind Uncle Sam. And these people consisted of federal elected and appointed officials, governors, and judges in their robes. Uncle Sam walked up to Lincoln and whispered in his ear and revealed tears running down his cheek. He choked back a sob, and he said, "Mr. Lincoln, you have been found guilty by those in power and are sentenced to death by hanging for it." Mr. Lincoln said, "As the former president of this union, I deserve to know what I am accused of to begin with. I am an attorney, and I know what the law says." Uncle Sam stated clearly and precisely and with great struggle, "We do not recognize the law of man or of God and simply find you worthy of death. Your time is over, and a new dawn awaits those who will dwell on this earth." And at this time, the men standing behind Uncle Sam came forward and they put a noose around Lincoln's neck and they tightened it. Then they pushed Uncle Sam forward while they threw the end of the rope over a marble brace at the memorial. And they handed the end of the rope to Uncle Sam and saluted him. Uncle Sam held that rope in his hands for a very long time and he wept. And then he faced Lincoln and he said, "I'm sorry, Mr. President." And at this statement, the men behind him pounded him about the head and neck until bruising began to appear in Uncle Sam's head. And they yelled at him and said this, "You address him as Mr. Lincoln, nothing more." Uncle Sam looked back at the men and said, "You can hang me next for what I've allowed you to do to my conscience." He then started pulling on the rope. President Lincoln stood quietly and began to feel the tautness of the rope when he reached backwards and began firing to grab something on his seat. As Uncle Sam strained to pull and hold the rope, Lincoln was trying to grab his Bible and was pushing the law books off of it, but his fingers were slipping off of the binding. He did get a hold of it, but the jerking of the rope made him drop it to the floor just as his feet left the floor. Lincoln's eyes, they showed compassion towards the elected and the appointed men in front of him. As Uncle Sam, holding the rope tight, would not look at anything but the floor. Most interesting note in the dream, Lincoln never fought back after the Bible slipped from his hands. And now he was just swinging slowly. One of the judges, not the federal officials, one of the judges, spoke up and said, "You can drop him now." And Uncle Sam very slowly and respectfully dropped Lincoln to the floor. He looked back at the men and he said, "I hope you get what you deserve for this." Then he held his chest and he dropped to the floor. He was dead within seconds with his eyes wide open, and the crowd began to scatter, including the elected and appointed men who had been behind him encouraging this whole endeavor. At that very moment, the man appeared that I had seen in the dreams for so often. He knelt down beside President Lincoln and said, "They didn't have any idea what they were doing, and now the nation needs to brace itself for what they deserve." He then walked over to Uncle Sam, closed his eyes tenderly and tapped the heart area 3 times, and he said, "Rest in peace, Uncle Sam. Sorry you had to see the ship go down." Then the man looked right at me in the dream, and he said, "Nation, specifically nation, brace yourself for fire and ice, and don't forget to anchor your soul."
Hi, my name's Mike, and today I've got a message to share from the 4-4 Prophecy news site called A Call to Battle, given to Roxanne on the 4th of September 2020. This is the message. "My children, hear my words. As calamity strikes, many areas will be unsafe to travel to. You must stay in constant communication with me this day forward. Your very lives depend on it. I have removed my hand from this filthy country. I can no longer hold off the judgments for the sake of my righteous few. Therefore, as I have promised, I cannot lie. I will guide you to safety is needed. Finish gathering my children. Finish your home services, my children. Prepare your life without electricity in many areas. You are entering a time when your relationship with me must be maintained. I will never leave you. Please do not leave me. Pray for souls to come to me before calamity strikes. I am allowing chaos. I allow order to fall by the wayside as a warning to all who have ears to hear and eyes to see. This is a call to battle, but not a weapon battle. This battle must be fought on your knees so I can release my angels to do my bidding, my will. I wish for no man to perish. This is why I am allowing job loss, riots, lack of food, lockdowns, etc. This is to get the attention of the lost, of my backsliders and all the churches who are asleep, not of me. Come out of her, my children. I am the way, the truth and the life. No man comes to the Father, my Father, except through me, Jesus. I am what you lack. I am the only one who can give you peace, salvation and order. Come to me, my children, come now. I will not heal your land. I will not restore America. Do not believe the lie of the enemy. No president or politician will fix what I have ordained. The fall of America will be in the fall. Buckle up. Judgment is here. My Father is angry. Those who know me will have peace under the worst circumstances. Know this, my children. I will envelop you with like a warm blanket. This will be the start of your great witness and harvest for me. Be ready. Tell them the good news. Salvation is near. And there's a scripture to read here, a couple of scriptures. Proverbs 4:10 to 11. Listen, my son, and receive my words, and the years of your life will be many. I will guide you in the way of wisdom. I will lead you on the straight paths. And Romans 8:17 to 21. For the gospel reveals the righteousness of God that comes by faith from start to finish. Just as it is written, the righteous will live by faith. God's wrath against sin. The wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all the ungodliness and wickedness of men who suppress the truth by their wickedness. For what may be known about God is plain to them because God has made it plain to them. For since the creation of the worlds, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood from his workmanship. So that men are without excuse. For although they knew God, they neither glorified him as God nor gave thanks to him, but they became futile in their thinking and darkening in their foolish hearts. And Revelation 12:17, and the dragon was enraged at the woman and went to make war with the rest of her children who keep the commandments of God and hold to the testimony of Jesus. And a dragon stood on the shore of the sea. And that's the end of the message. Anyone out there hasn't come to Lord Jesus, please don't wait. His time is running out. God bless you all. Bye-bye.
Hey, YouTubers. This is Glenda. Just wanted to bring you a word tonight from the Lord about the coming judgment on America. I've seen a number of visions about what is coming to this country. America is entering a very dark time. Some of the visions, visions of a very devastating famine, visions of nuclear attack, disease. There are a number of people that are having these visions right now and have been having them for years. I know of a couple of other people who have had very detailed visions. They are not believers at present, or say they're not. Very detailed visions about the nuclear attacks. One of them has the same dream over and over and has been having it for years about where he's looking out across the city he lives in and he sees an airplane fall from the sky, and right after he sees that, and then he sees me and T-Burst. He has military experience, so he knows what an EMP burst would look like, a bright flash of light, I guess. The other one has had the dreams for years and years, and they're so horrible he won't talk very much about the details, but what I've been able to learn so far is he feels in the vision dreams that multiple cities are struck at one time, at least three, maybe as many as six. Almost simultaneously, very much like the Twin Towers attack in September 2001. He's looking out across an industrial area in a very large city. He said these are the major, major cities in America. He doesn't know what the cities are. He couldn't identify for sure the time period, but he felt like it would be by December of a particular year, and I don't know the year, but he's looking out across an industrial area of a city, and he said that the devastation was unspeakable, that there were no words to describe the complete devastation that he witnessed and how horrible it was. So my point is, we are entering a very, very grave time as the body of Christ, and also the unbelievers are going to enter it. It's very important that we make sure that our hearts are right before God. And we need to constantly be examining our hearts and our lives and our motives to be sure that we are right with God, because when this kind of devastation starts to happen, there will be widespread terror. Many people will panic, especially people who don't know Christ. If you have a close relationship with God, you're going to be able to talk to Him and hear from Him, and you will know what to do. If you don't have a close relationship with Him, you will be among those who panic, and you won't know what to do. And, I mean, there's not any other way to walk out of time like that with any measure of calm. Unless you have a higher power, that being Jesus Christ. So, I want to talk about what do you worship? Who is your God? Our hearts are made to worship. We were created for worship. And the nature of our hearts is such that if we don't worship God, which is what we were made to do, our hearts will find something else to worship. And if we don't give God His proper place in our hearts, then something else will come in and fill that space, and we will worship that instead. And I want to talk about how you know what you worship, how you can tell if you're not sure, because
thank you, Jesus.
Glory to your name, O God. We're going to continue to worship the Lord with praises, adoration to you, O God. Oh, church, just take a couple of seconds and just worship Him. Thank Him. Just thank Him. Thank Him with your mouth. Hallelujah. God, we thank you for all that you have done, O God. Te damos la gracia, Cristo. We worship you, O God. Oh, why don't you just lift your hands and worship the Lord? He's worthy of worship. He's worthy of praise. Glory to you, Lord. We bless your name, oh Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Come on, church, just worship the Lord. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our glory, oh God. We give you honor, oh Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, oh God. Oh, let's sing that.
Our hope is built on nothing else. In Jesus' love and righteousness.
Christ the Lord.
Christ the Lord.
With me, he spoke over your life. Everything do it. God's gonna 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 do it. Do you believe it? God's gonna do it. God's gonna do it. Oh, I don't know who needs to hear that, but his promises are yes and amen. And I don't care what it looks like right now. Be encouraged, my brother, my sister. It's never over until God says it's over. And I don't know who needs to hear this, but I hear God say he's breathing on your situation right now. While you're in this sanctuary offering up a sacrifice, while you're saying, God, I will bless you at all times. No matter what I'm going through, no matter what the doctor said, no matter what my bank account looks like, no matter what's going on at home, still gonna lift up my hands and worship, because I believe that no weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against me shall be condemned. All things are working together for the good of those that love the Lord and that are called according to his purpose. You offer up a sacrifice. Woo. Woo. This battle is not yours, it belongs to God. So we say, King of Glory, we want you to feel this place. Anybody just want to be with him? Anybody really want more of his presence? Woo.
Father, we bless you, we glorify you. We worship you, Lord, with our mouths. We bless you, O God. Gracias, Señor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, church, just thank him no matter what you are going through. Just thank him and praise his holy name and know that he is able. He is able. He is able, Father. You are able, O God. A broken heart today, oh Jesus. Heal the sick today, oh God. Holy Spirit, have your way in this place. Holy, holy, holy you are, oh God. Oh church, just tell him how much you love him today. Father, we will bless your name, oh God. We will glorify your name. Magnify your name, oh God. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, oh God. You are holy, Jesus. Draw me close to you. all church with hands lifted, sing to the Lord, sing to the Lord. If you believe that, would you put your hands together? So, Lord, we tell you this morning that all we want is you. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for giving us a
amazing, amazing God. Then I shall
Father, we bless you, we glorify you. We worship you, Lord, with our mouths. We bless you, oh God. Gracias, Señor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, church, just thank him no matter what you are going through. Just thank him and praise his holy name and know that he is able. He is able. He is able, Father. You are able, oh God. Mend the broken heart today, oh Jesus. Heal the sick today, oh God. Holy Spirit, have your way in this place. Holy, holy, holy you are, oh God. Oh church, just tell him how much you love him today. Father, we will bless your name, oh God. We will glorify your name, oh Jesus. We will magnify your name, oh God. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, oh God. You are
you. If you believe that, would you put your hands together? So, Lord, we tell you this morning that all we want is you. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for giving us a
glory to your name, oh God. We're going to continue to worship the Lord with praises, adoration to you, oh God. Oh, church, just take a couple of seconds and just worship him. Thank him. Just thank him. Thank him with your mouth. Hallelujah. God, we thank you for all that you have done, oh God. Te damos la gracia, Cristo. We worship you, oh God. Oh, why don't you just lift your hands and worship the Lord? He's worthy of worship. He's worthy of praise. Glory to you, Lord. We bless your name, oh Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Come on, church, just worship the Lord. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our glory, oh God. We give you honor, oh Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, oh God. Oh, let's sing that.
Our hope is built on nothing else.
Christ alone.